And he is one of the rarest of artists who had a remarkable feeling for line. And you can see very clearly that 1962 was the period just before the Green Revolution. And India was finding its own sensibility. And here you can see that we have in Indian sculpture, in Indian art, the sense of Nandi. So the bull in the Spanish bullfight is killed. But here you can see this animal sort of, you know, rising up again from the dust. So he is not the Spanish bull who's ready to be sacrificed. He is the Spanish bull that has survived the fight.
I see. So,
and I won't say more, there's a Chinese war also.
Come again on the Sanjay, because I think the video got cut. So, Sunit, what do you think of this work, please? Tell me, what is it about this Sanjay Bhattacharya painting that you think is so special? You said it had a David Hockney feel, but Sanjay has never met David Hockney or never even looked at his work.
No, but he has developed landscape painting from realist landscapes and pictures that were made by his teacher, Bikash Bhattacharya.
Correct.
And he has brought it up to realistic landscapes where light and shadow play a very important role.
So he had gone for a camp, he said, and he went to this Mykonos, and he just loved what he saw, and he wanted to play on the white and blue which he saw in that entire landscape there.
Yes, and you can see it's not only just the white and blue, it's the way he has treated it. It is not simply realism, it is not impressionism, and it is not expressionism per se.
So what would you categorize it?
I categorize it as contemporary Indian landscape.
So it is a language of India.
It is the language of India, but in the
contemporary
experience of the world.
I see. Experience of the world.
The new Indian goes anywhere in the world as an equal. He is not a colonized person.
Okay, so let's go to the next work now. Which one would you like to show and Sunit talk about? Okay. So...
Okay.
Sunit, so you're walking towards it. I'm telling my audience that you're walking towards it. So this is a beautiful Hussein canvas that we have. Can you elaborate more on it, and why did you think of this work for Harvest, and what made you even look at this work? Because it's a 2006 Hussein canvas. So what is so special about this Hussein?
You see, there are three things that are very special about Hussein. One is that Hussein was very deeply linked to the sensibility of independent India. The horse is somebody who is making something of life. The whole concept was that the horse is an invincible element.
I see. It's an invincible element.
Yes. Okay. And this kind of painting shows you that the invincible element is not just an individual. It has the herd instinct. Today we hear about the herd instinct saving people from corona.
Correct.
But here you have the herd instinct at a period when corona was not even known.
But Sunit, this is a, since you know, like I'm just talking to you because, okay, fine, this is part of the work of Harvest Part 1, and we love this work because of its vibrance, color, everything.
It's but, not only the vibrant color, you look at the brush strokes.
Yes, what are you seeing in the brush strokes?
Brush strokes were in fact extremely sensitive brush strokes.
But this is a 2006 work, so it's a relatively new work. Why did you choose it for the catalogue? I mean, in that sense that, you know, we could have got an 80s or a 90s, but why is this work so special?
Because really, it is one of his last works that has the feeling of Hussein of the 60s and 70s.
How so?
Because A, the subject,
okay,
the horse.
Yeah.
Secondly, his treatment of colour.
Okay.
That goes back to his paintings of Rajasthan
Correct.
And the Ramayana paintings.
True, Rajasthan is one of his favorite subjects, that's right, in the 60s.
And it is an old artist actually living through the multiple experiences of his life and showing you that it is not only the individual, it is the whole herd.
And so Hussain used to revisit his subjects, which you had told me once. Why was that? Like, an artist is allowed to revisit his subjects?
Why not?
Okay.
If an artist doesn't revisit his experience, he is not able to develop a new one.
Okay.
You see Hussain paintings with one horse, two horses, maximum three. But here, he's got a whole herd. And this is a kind of challenge that he has picked up in his old age.
Okay.
And used elements of his different periods of painting and made it one masterpiece.
So the next work, Sumit.
There again, you find an artist.
Who is this artist?
This is Ram Kumar.
Okay. Why did you choose this work? It's a 2006 work of Ram Kumar.
I chose it because I find when an artist becomes older.
I'm just going to focus. Yeah, please go.
When an artist becomes older, he becomes much more experienced and much more sensitive to color and texture.
Okay.
And in this work, you find.
Please point out.
In this work, you'll see the colors are not just bright.
No, they're not.
They are very muted.
Correct.
This is very European in his style.
I see.
Yes.
I see.
Because the paintings of Europe, of Britain, and other artists of this period, they are not, in fact, sharp things coming straight at the eye. They don't hit you in the eye.
So what makes Ram Kumar a great abstractionist, landscapist, as we may call it, from India? What
he
is so special about him?
He's an abstractionist in the sense that Indian art is not simply what is called abstract.
Okay.
It is non-figurative art.
Correct. That's what you always say.
It is based on reality. So you have a landscape, you have bushes, you have fences, you have trees, you have huts. And that then develops into forms.
Yes.
So this is what I call classic Indian non-figurative art.
So Ram Kumar developed
it. He picks up from here.
Yeah.
This is a building. You can see what it is. And then it slowly disappears.
Okay.